Hi, and welcome to this watch new session for B1 Usability Package 2022.02. This is the first major release of 2022. It's both a small and a big release. Let me explain why I say that. So, first up, the requirements of the new release. You, of course, need to have paid your 2022 maintenance. And you need to run SubBusiness 110 FP 2102 or higher. I will get more into that in the next slide. Framework have not changed. You still need to have 4.7 and Office if you want to do integrations with Print and Delivery and so on. Is still a minimum requirement of 2013 or higher. But let's talk a little about SubBusiness 110. Because it is now that we say goodbye to the SubBusiness 1.9x release family. It's been out of maintenance for several years by SAP, and we feel at Boyum it's also time to say goodbye now in order for us to be able to use the 10 features, which we couldn't because of the backward compatibility and so on. So from this release on and onward, it will only be released as a SubBusiness 110 add-on, and by proxy, it will be only 64-bit. We will, of course, still allow you to run the 2021 X releases, which will still work on version 9.3, and if there's huge bugs, we will fix it, but else we will ask you to go to a supported version from SAP, meaning SubBusiness 110. We have also did some spring cleaning internally in that we are saying goodbye to our legacy features that was set into legacy a couple of years ago. So from this version, B1 Time Task will not be there anymore. B1 Document Manager will not be there anymore. B1 Budget and the plugin system that only worked on MS SQL. If you're using these features, you would either need to stay on the old versions or find alternative to those products. They will not be included in the version anymore. And at the same time, the B1 Time website will also go away very shortly. So this should not affect very many because there are very few users of this. So we're doing this to make the product more lean and focus on what is important in the product. Now on to some new features. There's only a few because it has been a huge undertaking to go SubBusiness 110 only in this area. But one of the things is some quality of life features. And these are just the first two of many you will see because 2022, we have a focus area around enhancing traceability of various automated tasks and features in order for you to actually do some self-help. So the first two is up in the Boyum support menu structure up here, which is lazy DIPI status and license status. These are mostly for support cases where you either have a slow system. We can check with this lazy DIPI status if there's some issues for you not being able to have fast connections. In the past, it was a bunch of articles and a bunch of different small things you needed to check here and there. Now this little tool will automatically show it to you. And in the same manner, if you had a license problem, you didn't have enough number of users and so on. It could be a pain to dig to different logs and so on. So now it's again up here. You can press license status, check exactly what happened during the license check of Boyum and see what license came back and why it is the way it is. So again, this is the first of many small features like that, which will be our main focus point of 2022 in order for you to actually be more efficient with your usability packets and better understand what's going on. The final thing I have here is something I would very much have loved to have in this version. It is actually ready, but due to a late found SAP bug, it unfortunately needs to be delayed. And that is our major feature for this release, which unfortunately will come in probably March or April, depending on SAP. But it is a new thing for the web client. The web client cannot do too much right now in terms of extensibility, but it is possible to make tiles that can go to other cloud apps and loosely coupled apps, like, for example, the Boyum cloud that I'm showing here. So we could just have released a small extension sending out all these tiles for you, but then you might not need build. You only needed produce, or you only needed inspect, and then the tiles would just be in your way. So what we have done instead is we have built a tool for you to make tiles on your own. So you're essentially having B1 up an add-on for Business One, building extensions for Business One, meaning for the web client. And the first one here is to build tiles. You can go in and build your own tiles. So for example, if you have a support page that you want your customers to visit when they have problems, or a place to log tickets for you, or the customer have a back-end service to a web shop, you can actually make that as tiles using usability package and then install it inside the web client. There will be more information once this is available, because again, right now it's coming soon due to this SAP bug. It would cause more hurt than good if we were to release right now. So we have agreed to, despite our eagerness to share this with you, also to wait until it actually works in a stable enough manner for you to actually work with. And this is just the first step in, again, a focus area of the B1 web client this year. And as SAP slowly gives us more and more features to work in here, it's very, very limited right now. But over time, as we grow with the web client and this extensibility model, we will offer you more and more features in here. What they are, I can't tell you exactly, because SAP have not shared it with us exactly when and where. But be sure that, like always, Boyum will be first mover with everything SAP does, and this is the first step. Again, unfortunately delayed, but I wanted to share it with you that this is coming fairly soon as SAP have fixed the bug. So with that, thank you for watching. As always, there's a preview out now if you want to try it out. But else, if everything goes as planned and looking fine so far, it will be released, this version, on the 8th of February 2022 on the normal download page. And again, remember, it's SubBusiness 110 only. So if you are not on SubBusiness 110 already, you should begin to prepare to get there so we can all share the new and cool features in the future. So that's the first step for 2022. Again, thank you for watching and have a nice day.